Comedy Time presents Comedy Brew, a delicious mix of short, fast, funny, featuring today's most hilarious comedians. So crank up the volume and switch off the light, and get ready to enjoy the sweet, fresh taste of comic goodness.
Hi, thanks for watching Comedy Time. We find the great comedians so you don't have to. I'm pretty sure I stole that slogan from a fast food joint.
Quit clapping, you never heard of me. Don't even front. All this shit I've been on, you ain't seen me on nothing. Only way you gonna get famous in America is American Idol or a Bin Laden tape. Them the only two shit you can get on and be a star the next day. Some of you in here dating, that's cool. That's cool. I suck at love, man. You ever been on a date so bad the girl make you drop her off at another dude's house? You ever been through that? Who knows pain? Me, I'm the only one gonna open up tonight. This is a true story. My last relationship was like 3-4 years ago. I broke up with this girl. The night we broke up, she called me 3 a.m, shaking sleeping pills into the phone, faking her own suicide. Cause she can't deal with the breakup. I swear to God, 3 a.m, you hear that, Roy? I'm going to sleep cause you don't love me. Nobody loves me. And she hung up and sent text messages every 30 minutes to let me know when she had taken a few more pills, which was pissing me off because I was over my text limit for the month, so I'm trying to block them. I don't know who you got, but I got Sprint. That's 10 cents a pop. You got something to say, you call me and say the shell. I don't need you running up my text message every 20 minutes. I'm getting a text, 14 pills, 22 pills. I just took 33 sleeping pills. Ain't you gonna say something? Why aren't you asleep yet? How about that? How long did it take 33 sleeping pills to kick in? And I'm not saying I condone suicide. I don't want y'all to think I'm an a**hole, but you gotta agree, if you're gonna kill yourself, the least you could do is get name brand pills that's effective and work fast. God, this is your last day on earth. Spoil yourself, get the good stuff. What are you saving money for, Cheryl? Write a check, you ain't gonna be here when the check bounces. Go to sleep. It's a true story, you can laugh all you want. This is my pain. Enjoy yourself.
Hey, I'm Kirk Zippo, and you're watching Comedy Time. Isn't the internet great? It was like it was invented to kill time. Here's the next comic.
Beige man, like I said, you know, we don't have much history. Don't. Dark-skinned black people got everything. They got Dr. King, Malcolm X. You know what we got, light-skinned people? You know what we have? Iced tea. And not even 1992 iced tea, the pimp man, you know what I'm saying? We got iced tea now, saving white girls on NBC at 10 p.m. You know what I mean? That iced tea, you know? Which is an awesome show, by the way. I love that show. Very, very good show. You know, we don't have a symbol. Black people got the symbol, they got the fist. Yeah, punch you in the face. Kill whitey in the mouth, whatever. You know what I'm saying? That's what they do. White people even got the Hitler thing, whatever that was. It was hot when it was hot. You know what I'm saying? I'm not hating, it was hot. It had its moment, had its day in the sun. That's all you need to know, right? Like mixed people, you know, us, we don't have a symbol or anything to show our pride. You know what I mean? I'm gonna make a symbol. You know what I mean? It's gonna be some dude just standing there like this. Wearing a t-shirt saying we're trying, you know what I mean? Like, we'll be a race, guys. Give us time. I live in Washington Heights. Live in Washington Heights, and there's a lot of Spanish people up there. You know, I was chilling with this one Spanish chick. She had like 5 kids, right? So, really, you know, Spanish kids, they're known for having kids. So we're chilling, we're sitting there on the couch, you know, kissing. I'm not really cool with girls. I don't know how to say nothing to a girl, so we're kissing, getting real cool and getting real heated and hot, right? And she turns to me and she goes, Bobby, say something to me I never heard before. I was like, oh, shoot, like, how do I do this and keep my G up, keep my G stuff up? So I look at her, she looks at me, I look back at her, We have this little moment, and I say to her, I don't mind that you have 5 kids. I got some though, I got some. She gave it up, man. That's how you get it, yo. That's how you get it.
Hi, I'm Suna Bilstead for Comedy Time. They say laughter is the best medicine. I hope this next comedian is funny because my insurance doesn't cover my antipsychotic medication.
Congress wants to build a 3,000 mile long wall 30 feet high between the US and Mexico. What a waste of money. You build a 30-foot-high wall between the U.S. and Mexico, Mexico become the largest producer of 31-foot extension ladders. Pole vaulting become their new national sport. They'll be like, yes, we can, si se puede. Heck yeah, you build that wall high enough between the U.S. and Mexico, Mexico launched their own space program. We have the Apollo space program, they'll have the Apoyo Loco space program. Heck yeah, it's a 3,000 mile long wall ain't gonna stop crap. 3,000 miles of shark infested waters and a leaky boat did not stop the pilgrims. As our ancestors call it, the worst surprise costume party ever. Right. Not even a full blood, but we still got to put up with the stereotypes, right? Huh? I'm not from the reservation. I didn't have my first drink till I was almost 12. Right? That's what everyone thinks. Native Americans can't handle their liquor. I'm like, bull crap. Midgets can't handle their liquor. They busted the father from the Little People Big World TV show for DUI. Now they got him in a 6-step program.
What's up, Comedy Time viewers? If you're in need of a good laugh, you're in the right place. If you need a good lawyer, nah, I can't really help you there. But before you make any moves, watch this next comic.
My friends think I'm too picky. They're like, you can't just trust me. You can't just not go out with the guy because, you know, he doesn't have a job or a car because he's a small penis. He could be good at other things. Like what, math? What? I have a girlfriend who's dating a guy who doesn't even have a car. It's like, okay, this isn't high school. This isn't Manhattan, you know? You need to get a car. I don't care if it's a piece of car. I used to drive a Toyota Echo. Okay, I don't know if you all know what that looks like, but it's so little you don't even have to put it in reverse. You just pick it up and turn it around. A solid one night stand in LA. I tried to bring some waiter home with me on New Year's. I put in like 2.5 hours of prime time Chelsea time. No? And we get back to my place. He goes, I don't feel comfortable spending our first night together. It's like, listen, Lupe, this is our last night, all right? Get your hopes up. Get out that pinata. Let's get this party started. There's some sick stuff going on in LA with men, single men. I want to talk about it, okay? I want to talk about it. And now I'm just as much of a romantic as the next girl. But if I'm dating / sleeping with a guy and he shows up on my doorstep with beads and a flashlight, I'm going to ask a couple of questions. Like, what's up with the flashlight? Do you guys think it's okay to drink while you're pregnant if you're planning on giving the baby up for adoption?
Ooh.
What's up, and thanks for watching Comedy Time. They say you can attract more flies with honey than with vinegar, but does anyone actually want to attract flies? They aren't even funny. Think about it while you enjoy our next comic.
Wonder.
Originally from back east, how many people from back east? All right, Africa. Madagascar, I got people there. From New York, man, I just got back from New York. I love how they're trying to fight crime in New York, and the subways, they have this big campaign, placards all over the subway. If you see something, say something. Screw you, Homeland Security, do your damn job. If you see something, say something. It's not gonna work. You know, it's not gonna work because if you see something means if you see something outside your own comfort zone. But everybody has their own comfort zone. So what does that mean? If you see something, say something. You're gonna have people going up to cops going, excuse me, officer. Yeah, I just saw a black guy reading the Wall Street Journal. He said, if I see something, say something. There's a French guy putting on deodorant right over there. You might want to investigate that. Jewish guy tipping 20%. What is that? Seriously. He said, if I see something, say something. Oh, don't look down, but there's a Mexican girl with one baby. What is that? Mexican girl, one baby? Hysterical! You don't even have to be here. I'll do the laughter. That was genius. I'm kidding. I love the Latinos. We got Latinos here? Of course. It's America. I'm half Latino myself. I love Latinos. Beautiful. I mean, the girls. Am I right? Oh, there's a Mexican girl that works on my block, walks past my house every day. Ah. Oh. I took 4 years of Spanish. I don't remember nothing. I tried to talk to her. I'm like, hola. ¿Dónde está la biblioteca? That's right, where's the Bible? All right. Just beautiful on the bodies, am I right? Just developed, just bam, chest, bam, at legs, back, 12 years old. What the hell is going on? I would have stopped and talked to her, but she was pregnant. But her second baby, yes! We keep going deeper, folks, cause it's...
Hi there. This is Josh Cheney from Comedy Time, bringing you some of the best stand-up comedy you can find. This next, hey, don't check your Facebook. That's not the time for this. This next comedian's really good, I swear. If you don't believe me, right after you're done, you can tweet about how hard you laughed. Everyone will think you're super cool, whatever.
I was walking out of the Pottery Barn in my three-quarter length pants and sleeveless tee. This lady with a clipboard said, excuse me, sir, do you have time to save the rainforests? I said, you know what, I'm sorry, I don't, I'm extremely busy. And then I went directly home and updated my MySpace profile. I had like all these new pictures to add and I changed my whole about me section. Hate the rainforests. There's this scene in Romeo and Juliet when Leonardo DiCaprio and Claire Danes see each other for the first time. It's like one of the most romantic things. It's through a fish tank that they see each other. Ironically, the same thing happened to me last week at my orthodontist. Me and this girl saw each other and finally we were face to face at the end and I don't know. She was like 7. I mean, they say the fish tank adds like 6 years, but... I feel like a turtleneck is kind of like a crew neck that hasn't been circumcised. People always say, Nick, you are so tall. What's stopping you from playing basketball? So the other day I tried this on someone else. I was like, hey, Mike, you are so average. What's stopping you from getting a job at IKEA? I got one of those best friend forever necklaces that splits in half. I gave half of it to this girl that I really like, that I want to start dating. And then I gave the other half, along with a forged note that says, let's just be friends, to her boyfriend.
What's up? It's Arana, and you're watching Comedy Time. Hey, what did the fish say to the clam? It doesn't matter. It was underwater. Did you really expect me to translate fish talk? Of course you didn't. You. You're good, you. Now check out this next comic.
Thanks very much for having me. It's nice to be out of the house. I have kids, and my wife and I are very fortunate. A few years ago, we were told that we were unable to have children by our landlord. Yeah. My wife first got pregnant. I didn't realize. She wasn't feeling well. I didn't think anything of it. Then she started throwing up every morning and putting on weight, and then it occurred to me, she's got a drinking problem. So we have two kids. We picked out kind of old-fashioned names for our kids. Our little boy's Hunter, and our little girl is Gatherer. Names you don't hear a lot of anymore. But I remember about a week before my little boy was born, I went to buy a baby carriage. And the really nice baby carriages were $500 or $600. So that's when we decided that we're going to have an indoor baby. We clipped his nails. Of course, it's very different being a parent these days. Every kid is on medication these days. Both my kids are on Rogaine. They insisted. One thing that's helped us, about a year ago, we instituted something called Family Night, where we set aside one night a week for each of us to spend the night with a different family. Just to kind of break up the monotony. As much as I love being a parent, it's so nerve-wracking because you're just constantly worrying. You know, what if they're not mine? It never ends. And I love my parents, but they made some mistakes, you know. My brother Vivian is still bitter. Let it go, Viv. My brother called me last night to complain that his teenage daughter dresses too sexy, because she doesn't wear a bra and she should, and her shirt never covers her belly, and half the time her butt crack is exposed. It made me realize that my dad dresses too sexy. Dad, you're a skank.
Hey, what's up? This is Shang, and this is Comedy Time. You smell that? I'm sorry, my bad. Wow, pizza. Listen, I'm not smarter than a fifth grader, you know that? But you know what? I can probably beat most fifth graders up in a fight. Enjoy this next comic for the love of Buddha.
In New Jersey, we have this cute little game we like to play with the cops in New Jersey. It's called racial profiling. Now, unfortunately, white people, you cannot join this club. No matter how much you tan, you're not included in this club. See, what the cops like to do, they like to pull us over and they like to ask us trick questions so they can hit us in the head with that stick. But I'm too smart for that because I went to high school 7.5 years, so Anytime I'm in New Jersey, I fight fire with fire. I drive up the New Jersey Turnpike on the wrong side of the road. 95 miles an hour. Cell phone in one hand. Rolling weed. No, just cell phone in one hand. Wait for the cops to pull me over. And they, woo, woo, woo. They come knocking on the door. And then the roller window down. Excuse me, sir. Do you know how fast you're driving? Like if I say 50, you go, yeah, 50. Go ahead. I was just checking. Go ahead. Keep going. I'm like, how fast are you driving? You were behind me. How fast are you driving? I was driving fast. That's why we're having this conversation, officer. Then they always like to ask the black man the most demeaning question. Especially got a really nice car. He goes, whose car is it? Right? And that's the last thing you expect to be asked when it's yours. So when he goes, whose car is it? You go, yeah, whose car is it? And then you see the registration. Wait a minute, this is my car. See, they never get me, folks, as that GED starts kicking in. So I know he's joking. He goes, whose car is it? I'm like, I'm sorry, y'all. So I didn't get the name of that white lady that I took it from because it was a carjacking and she was upset and I didn't think it was the appropriate name to ask. But I think of her name. I think her first name is Help, Help, because that's all she kept saying. But she's in the trunk if we really need her name. I got her in the trunk. See, most of y'all get it. Some of y'all like the cops. You don't see how funny that is. And then it gets personal. You mind stepping outside your car? I'm like, yeah, man, it's raining. Can't you kick my butt inside my car? I just did my hair. And I'm not trying to act tough, folks. I'm just trying to say I'm not afraid of the police because I'm from New Jersey. I've been on a first name basis with the police ever since I can remember. I'm serious, until I was 14, I thought my nickname was Freeze. Yeah. You know how mad I was when I saw him call someone else Freeze? I'm like, hey, that's my nickname. He's get up against the wall, I'm Freeze.